Fars here. I'm with Martin again. We are at SPS Show here in Nuremberg, Germany. And Martin has something really cool, like an application from PLCnext that wants to share with you guys.
Thanks, Shaku. So what we're showing is how to remotely control a machine from several hundred kilometers away. So what we have is on my desk in my office in Bad Pyrmont near Hanover, that's about 300 kilometers away, we have a PLC that's running Node Red. And that's listening, that's subscribed to an MQTT broker. And it's waiting for commands to come through from that MQTT broker. And so the way we're going to publish commands to that broker is using this voice control unit. So this is a voice recognition unit. It'll translate my voice commands into JSON strings, and then it will publish those JSON strings to an MQTT broker.
Just one question. This setup that we have here doesn't have anything to do with voice
or... No, this is running different applications for our demonstration.
Yeah, this is like a different thing. You can just filter this one when you're watching. So this is the setup that we have is this one that is connected to the computer.
Yeah, so this is connected directly to the internet, and this is really just a copy of the PLC that's running on my desk back in my office. So that's what it looks like in my office. We've got this voice control box connected to the PLC, and it's waiting for my voice commands. When it hears the correct command, it will send the JSON string up to an MQTT broker in the cloud. Hopefully this PLC on my desk will hear that command and it will operate the machine. So I'll give it a try. Our voice control unit is called Bob, so I'll just say hello to him.
Yeah.
Hello, Bob. Machine on. And now we see the green light go on the machine, and we see the actuators pushing a little parcel around on the machine, and after a few seconds everything retracts, and then we see the parcel get conveyed onto the little platform, and then the light goes off. The operation is complete. So this is the demonstration of how we can use MQTT, just open source libraries and software on a PLCnext control to control machines remotely.
And also maybe you can share some information about how these connection works.
So in this case, we're using a public MQTT broker from a crowd called Mosquito. They host the public MQTT broker
it's
in
like
the cloud.
A cloud, a different version of it. It's a cloud.
You could treat it like a cloud service. So this is also applicable for Amazon Web Services if you use AWS, or if you use Microsoft Azure. You can also use the same principle to send MQTT messages or messages in any other format that's supported by that cloud service. You can send those messages directly from a PLCnext control up to those cloud services, and and then do whatever you want to do once it's in the cloud service, including remote control of the machine.
Yeah, this is very cool what we have here. So we are just sending the command, the voice command, just Martin said, like machine on. It goes to the cloud, and then from the cloud, we are connected to the cloud. And then here, this is like, we are at the like south of Germany. This setup is in the north of Germany, Bad Pyrmont. And then we send it to the cloud, and this setup is receiving the data from the cloud. And that's how we can control this machine from this distance. So this is like a very cool application of what you can do with a PLC. You can just say machine on, and you can just turn on the machine wherever you, like regardless of where you are in the world, which is like really cool for me.
And people have implemented something similar using Alexa or using Google Assistant as the voice control unit, which is obviously free, or if you have those devices. So you can actually control your PLCnext control using Alexa or using your Google Assistant. Now, in an industrial application, some people aren't so comfortable with their data going through Google servers. So this MQTT application that we have here, you can set that up as a completely private cloud service, your own private MQTT broker on your own private web server. You can encrypt your messages using transport layer security, X509 certificates. The whole thing is secure and controlled by you. So
you can either do this with like something like Alexa or Google, what was
it? Google Assistant or Google
Assistant,
Home. Yeah.
Yeah, a Google Home. Or if you are like concerned about the security of the data, you can have your own Alexa. Right?
Yeah, that's right. So this is a third-party device from another manufacturer.
There's more like an industrial version of that.
Yeah, exactly. And you can do all this through your own private cloud services. So yeah, so we sort of cater for all those different
possibilities. Okay, yeah, thanks guys for watching. Just wanted to share this with you. I think you'll find it interesting as well.